Hello, everybody. Welcome to Brothers Thrice. We are three brothers who grew up in a close, tight-knit family, but we have vastly different interests and hobbies and different opinions on a whole lot of stuff. So this leads to plenty of heated debates. I am Brian, joined by my brothers.
Hey, I'm Will. What's going on?
Kevin, how you doing?
And today, this episode of Brothers Thrice, we are discussing and battling out our top three video games.
Video games.
Oh, yeah.
And we are sticking with the bracket format. So
it just
seems
it's more fun that way, I think.
Well, yes. it gives to head like to a head. Head-to-head type feeling, which is very good.
Very good.
Very good. I'm like looking at this bracket right here.
You go look up the bracket on all our socials. It's a tough bracket. There's some matchups in here that I'm not looking forward to, and some that I think are going to be blowouts, and we don't know though, because I know what I think, but we got to see how it shakes out. That's why it's lucky we have three. There's never a tie.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Because some people
that's what upset. Our parents had in mind the whole time. They're like, how many kids should we have? Oh, well, you know, if one day they have a podcast and they're putting things head to head,
voting,
they have to have a tiebreaker.
An
so
odd number.
It is.
That's it. That's why our Supreme Court has 9 justices. That's why we have 3 brothers.
Yes.
That's the reason.
All right.
No ties.
Could have gone 5. That'd be a little too much on kids.
That's too much. That's too many.
Yeah.
Well,
imagine we had 2 more siblings. God.
There's so much less food.
So much less space. Imagine our rooms are as small as they were.
Well, I don't know if they would.
Imagine
they might not have stayed in the house if they had 2 extra siblings. We don't know.
If we had those twin girls that mom always wanted, then maybe it would.
Well, they would have to share a room. Then I'd be stuck in a room with you, Bri. And Will would have his own room.
Out of my own room? Hell yeah.
Or we might have just moved.
Or just moved. Even though we never, I was born into that house and never. And then when I left the house, I was never went anywhere.
Yeah,
literally, there's video of me, being born, brought into the brand. Like, not well, they had it for a couple of years.
He was born in that house.
I was born in the bathtub.
Nah.
All right, enough of that. Let's get this party started.
Who wants to see the story of our births?
It was a dark and stormy night.
You hit the paint on them.
We're gonna start quoting the Raven. That's how you were born.
Nevermore.
A tap tap Nevermore. Tapping on my chamber door.
Tap tap tapping on my mother's downstairs.
Oh.
It was me. Uterus. It was me coming through. I had a beak.
God.
All right, video games.
5 minutes in, we got weird.
We love video games. Who doesn't? Well, I guess there's some people who don't, but
we've been
into video games for since the PS1, I think was our first. Or technically, was Game Boy before PS1?
Yeah, I think the first one we had was N64.
No, we had PlayStation.
No, PlayStation 1, and then I think N64 is right. Not I think it was around the same time or a little
when
after.
When did PlayStation 1 come out? I think PlayStation 1. Well, N64 came out in 96, I believe.
No, but I know it doesn't matter which one came out first. We got PlayStation first because I remember getting it for Christmas before we had the N64.
Oh, actually, yeah. PlayStation 1 came out 94. In 1994.
I was literally looking it up too.
And N64 came out in 1996. Wow.
Right.
I thought that the OG that we had was always N64.
No, I remember we would play N64 all the time when we would go to piano lessons.
Yeah, we played the Mario, Super Mario.
Yeah, Super Mario 64.
N64, yeah.
Like, we would go, like, and Will would
whoever wasn't doing the lesson.
Piano, and then the other person would be playing Mario 64. And I remember wanting to go to play piano lessons all the time, not to learn the piano.
No.
Just so
I was like, can I? It's like, do you want to go first or second? He's like, I'll go second.
You go first.
But then sometimes I wanted to finish it, like finish off playing the game and then just get the piano out of the way so I could play the N64.
Yeah, and because Kev would probably take longer because he sucks at piano.
Yeah.
Hey.
Hey.
We both sucked. We were like 10.
Yeah, we're not. Yeah.
Too bad.
Well, yeah, I know we learned like Hot Cross Buns and Mary Had a Little Lamb.
I can still play Mary Had a Little Lamb, and that's the only thing I can play in the piano, and I'm pretty proud of that.
I can play Heart and Soul, and that's about it.
I don't know what that is.
Yes.
Okay. Video games.
Yeah, about that.
So PS1 was our first things and we loved it and just kind of went, we were kind of PlayStation boys forever. Now, well, now you guys are changing sides with the getting Xboxes, Brian.
Mm-hmm. Traitor.
I'm a PlayStation boy. I'm going to eventually get the PS5, but whenever that, I'm not rushing to get it. It's more like when I'm able to, and also when like there's supply out there, because it's very tight to get right now.
This episode of Brothers Thrice is brought to you by Sony. Sony, send us some PlayStations because we just sponsored you. Thank you very much.
Well, I mean, a decent amount of our stuff too is also Nintendo. So I feel like I'm still a Nintendo. I feel like it's Xbox or PlayStation, and then everybody enjoys Nintendo.
Yeah, everyone enjoys it because like you can't not play like Mario Kart and have a good time. Like, God. All right, let's just jump into our first matchup though. 8 and 9 seed. You got Super Smash Brothers, which is a classic, and also another Nintendo, Breath of the Wild, Zelda Breath of the Wild, the newer side for Wii U and Switch, which is a gorgeous
question
game.
Question for clarification. On the bracket that has the image of the Super Smash Brothers for the N64. Now, is this seed just the N64 Smash, or is it?
I think it kind of
the umbrella of Smash.
It encompasses, I think, the whole thing because it's all. It's just like it's the same game. It's just like better graphics and then more people. Fair. Like the game itself is pretty much the same gameplay at least.
Okay, so it will be Super Smash as a franchise.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I also have that
same,
for.
Does the same go for Pokemon then?
I would say so. Because
probably.
And I also have Ratchet and Clank on here, and that I feel like that's also a series. Because also going back and playing the original one on PS2 would probably not be as fun as playing the ones that are more, you know, more updated from there.
Okay.
Yeah, but like as a series, I guess. Like, okay. We'll say if it's not.
Yeah. We'll use our best judgment here for those that count in the series versus ones that are standalone, which there are a few. Then we'll figure it out.
Yeah. So Smash versus Breath of the Wild.
All right. So whose picks are these?
Smash is mine.
And Breath of the Wild is mine.
Is mine. I think my number three. I believe
this is also my number three.
Gotcha. Okay.
I guess
so. I'm the vote that counts.
So should I start with a Smash breakdown?
By all means.
What can I say? Super Smash Brothers is just like the best. Sit on the couch with your friends or family and just play and have a good competitive time. And it just, you can like, it's even though it's the same gameplay, like every time, technically like you're fighting as different characters, blah, blah, blah. So there's not much of a story to it, but it really is just like having that togetherness and like how we would play on N64 and beyond for hours, just like different kind of matchups. Okay. This time we'll do random characters. This time we can pick a different one. We'll do this hard course. And it was just nonstop fun. Unless there was someone who was much, much better, then it wasn't fun because then they just dominate every time.
Like when we play with our cousin Michael.
Shout out Michael.
Just kick our ass every single time.
Because we never had the GameCube. We jumped from the N64 to the Wii. So we never had GameCube. We never had Melee.
We hopped generations.
And he had Melee and it would just be... Every time we'd go, it was slow.
We would just be massacred every time. Every family function that we would go to their house, we would just in the basement. As soon as we get there, Melee for like 6 hours, and we would
until the food was served, or we were leaving.
Yeah.
Yep.
And it was always winner stayed on, and he would just play the whole time because nobody would ever beat him.
Yeah.
But also in college, like we had an N64 in our dorm room, and literally, I think we had like a thing like, okay, everyone would like shower and get ready for bed, and then we'd literally sit for like the last 2 hours or so before bed, like, oh, smash for like a little bit, and then we play a couple of matches, and like, all right, I think it's time for bed, and then we turn it off. But that was like every single night in college, me and my roommates.
Crazy guys.
We're like, guys, want to play some Smash? But and then get to bed, it's a school night. Oh. So,
I did the same thing in college senior year. Shout out Jake.
So like last year,
we would 2 years ago, we would sit in his room and play Super Smash Brothers on his Switch, the newest Super Smash Brothers Ultimate. Yeah, and
if they make another one though, what are they supposed to call? Because if they make this one called it Ultimate, can you go bigger than Ultimate?
Super duper Ultimate.
Platinum.
I think they're just planning on like just continuing to add to that one until like it's
probably
just bloated and crazy.
But on this Nintendo Switch, it gives you statistics for like playing the game. It says how many hours played. For the spring semester of 2019, we played that game. I think we got up to like 500 hours.
That's disgusting.
Super Smash Brothers, because we played every night of the week for hours every night, and yeah, it's
addicting. As soon as it's always like, oh, it was a close match. One more, and then just you keep going until like you were, I guess, satisfied. But you usually weren't never satisfied.
So
never
good.
Be satisfied. Shout out Hamilton.
Nice.
Lin-Manuel. You ever listened to Hamilton or watched Hamilton?
It's on Disney Plus, man.
You should watch. It's a good time.
Sorry.
It's very good.
All right, so, well, versus Zelda Breath of the Wild, the newest Zelda on Wii U, and then came to Switch. Brian, take the floor. It's a gorgeous game.
Yeah. So, I mean, I said a lot of good things about Super Smash Bros. Because how could you not? However, this one was my number three pick in there. 2017 coming out, like Will said, Switch and Wii U. Great, great game. Actually, the first and only Zelda game that I have ever played. Surprisingly enough, it's up there, but I've never played Ocarina of Time, which people say is one of the best great games of all time.
You know what? I think I did play a Game Boy
Zelda we had.
I think we had a Zelda for a Game Boy that I remember playing, like the 2D where you kind of like
above, and there was like going the around, seasons the would change, and you have knock down the bushes. Yes, I definitely remember that game. Okay, I don't remember one it was.
That was I think it had to do seasons was probably in the name, because it had a big time to do with seasons.
Yeah.
People are probably yelling like, "Oh, it's Seasons of Wild or whatever the name of it was."
Seasons of Wild.
I don't know. It's something like that. But yeah, I played that one. That the Breath of the Wild is like my more like I actually got into it. Where before I was like I didn't really follow that. Are you looking it up, Kev?
Yeah.
I saw the eyes looking frantic. Continue, Bryce. Sorry.
Breath of the Wild is so good because I'm a big, big fan of the open world kind of games where you could just go and do whatever you want. There is a great main quest line that you have to do to defeat Ganon and all that stuff across Hyrule. But there are so many other things that you can do throughout the entire game. You could just walk, like what I do, and I've played this game for quite some time, I just walk around and do random quests here and there, get some shrines and really beef myself up if I want to, and then go back to it. I recently started another game save. I beat the game once and then I started a new one and I haven't touched the main quest line whatsoever. I would just do my own thing.
I would just fly to get to like the highest peak I could, just like work on like getting up a mountain for like a good like hour probably. And finally get up there and be like, wow. And then like just like look out at everything. And like the game design is beautiful. And like open world is it seems so huge, even though it is. But it's just also like just like, and being able to climb anything is the best mechanic in any game. Because in a lot of like other games, like you have to, like they have a certain specific parts. Like, okay, you climb here and that's it. But like you just jump on any side of a hill or anything and just start, just in the trees, anything you want. And just start climbing. It's such an awesome
That's one of my favorite parts that you can do that. But a lot of people are given like some beef with this game about that, saying like, oh, Breath of the Wild is more of a climbing simulator than it is anything else. Yeah, that's what they said. And I'm like, that's one of the coolest
part
parts.
Of it. It's a part of it, but I don't think it's there's so much more than just climbing.
Yeah. So
I love that part of it.
Yeah. It's a really great mechanic. And I have found armor, a full set of climbing gear. So without the gear, you're just going,
you go fast
with the whole set, you go all of it's great. That's one of my
right, you
first
froze right as you went.
I did. Oh, oops,
like a second. It was just funny. Like,
now yeah, I so just for, I bought, well, you guys, I forget, I think it was Will or Brian when I first got the Switch, one of you bought me Breath of the Wild. So I didn't buy it. I only played it for like maybe an hour, and then I also got Super Smash at that time. I got other games. So it was like, I kind of had a plethora of games to play and I never played Zelda. I kind of just sat in my cabinet and I never played it. I'd say a week ago, I started playing it again. Just like, all right, I'm going to sit down and this is going to be the only game I'm going to play. Cause it's it's won awards. I'm pretty sure it won Game of the Year in 2017. It's because of such a high score on everything that rates it. So I was like, I'm going to sit down. I'm going to play this game. And when I first played it, it frustrated me because there's so much to do, but they don't tell you anything.
Right. And you gotta get a little bit into it before you actually like can like kind of really do everything.
And I started to like figure it out. And also, you have to go to these shrines in the beginning of the game, and there's a shrine on top of a mountain and it's freezing. and I kept dying because I was cold. I'm like,
you gotta eat the spicy peppers, bro.
Yeah, I didn't know that. And then I found these spicy peppers. I had to cook them, and then I had cold resistance. Or there's also a hut that you find a random hut. You just happen to stroll in. There's a chest, and you find cold gear.
Yeah.
To wear. And if you don't know that, you're just struggling to get up to this.
I did do some Google searches. I think here and there.
After I did, a little bit of just walkthroughs, just to understand how the game works. I said, all right, now I'm starting to enjoy it. I haven't done any of the quest lines. I've just been exploring, getting shrines and getting to those watchtowers and uncovering the map.
I was doing that first. I hate not having the map filled out.
Yeah. So I've been really enjoying. And also the combat I feel like is fun. And because the timing of it, to get those dodges so you can get the flurry rush in there. I love paragliding into slow motion using the bow. It's been a lot of fun. And the fact that it's a game that you can this is a shout out mostly to the Switch, that you can play on the TV, but then also play it handheld. Because in my apartment, me and my wife only have one TV. So it's hard for me to tell, she works from home on a laptop, for 8 hours a day. And it's hard for me to say all right, you're done working. I want to play a video game on the TV. So go back and look at the laptop that you've been staring at for the last 8 hours.
That's how you terrible. Talk to your wife, Kevin. Come on.
No, I don't say that. That's why I feel terrible if I was to say that. So it's hard to play PlayStation when, she just gets off work. She wants to, watch something on Netflix or whatever. So having the handheld Switch, it's like, oh, okay. You can watch, whatever, chick flick you want or whatever show that I'm Walmart not interested movie. In. Yeah. Then I can just play the Switch handheld. And I get to enjoy those games more frequently than I would if it was just on the TV. But that's also just a Switch thing, not just necessarily a Zelda thing.
Breath of the Wild.
Shout out Nintendo.
No, they're apparently coming out. I think they're supposed to do during the E3 weekend. I think this weekend or next weekend, I believe. And they may be announcing a new Switch Pro, a more beefy setup, I guess. Because they had the smaller ones, so the Joy-Cons don't come off the
Switch Lite.
So yeah. That they're gonna have light, they're gonna have the regular, and they're gonna have a pro model, I guess. And I'm guessing the pro model will be because there's some games I feel like Breath of the Wild, I'm surprised runs so clean on there. But I think if you have other games that are console level games, just be playing on that little thing sometimes could be.
Yeah, I have The Witcher 3, and it's tough to play on the handheld because there's a lot going on.
Big worlds with a lot of graphics. Think about it, it's only that thin little thing, it needs some computing power. So I don't know what it's going to look like, if it's going to be beefier or it's going to be what it's going to look like. Maybe a bigger screen maybe they'll go. I don't know.
That's probably what they'll do. Because I feel like when I'm going handheld to play bigger games like that, like Breath of the Wild or something like that, I feel like I have to hold it a centimeter away from my eyes to really see what's going on or get a good look if I'm shooting some bow or whatever.
If you also play it on the TV a lot, when I played Switch here and there, I play on the TV a lot. And when you go back to handheld, it feels really small just because you're used to the
screen. Well, yeah.
That's I play it mostly handheld, so when I go to the screen, it's like, ooh.
Holy shit.
This is nice.
It's a treat.
Yeah, so it's a little nice treat. So I guess...
Okay, let's vote on this thing.
Yeah, are you guys sticking with your original picks?
As overall video games and the amount of... I do love Breath of the Wild, but I gotta stick with Smash just because the amount of time I've put into it. And also, it's a friend, and we've played as brothers. It's a good couch co-op, not co-op, but a fighting game that's just a good time for everybody.
Yeah. I put in Breath of the Wild, but I'm the matchup here is just, you can't beat Super Smash Brothers. So I'm going to also have to go with Super Smash Brothers.
Whoa, you're
switching vote. Oh, okay.
It doesn't even matter what you say. Yeah.
It doesn't matter my vote, but my vote was, honestly, going to be Breath of the Wild.
Because really?
Super Smash is great. But it's only fun when you have somebody to play with.
True.
If you don't have anybody to play with, you don't play that game. And true. It's hard. I mean, especially now when everybody's got a lot going on to get somebody to play a game with you at a specific time.
For sure. So difficult. I think it's also the nostalgia of it for me too, where it's literally growing up, we played that so much. I played it so much in college, stuff like that, where it's that stuff still resonates now. So even though now we haven't played Smash in a while, of course, but still it's having that past with it gives it
an edge
over Breath of the Wild.
I just think Breath of the Wild it gives you a, it's a better game altogether. And
it's a totally Switch, different game though. It's totally different.
Yeah, it's a different type of game, but also like especially with the new Super Smash, the amount of characters that they have, it just bothers me. It's too many. And also, more than half of them are all the same.
Like you have person with sword.
Yeah, or like
you person know, with sword versus that, person with sword.
Yeah, it's getting to a fact where it's like almost overdone.
They gotta pick like cooler character, different characters.
And I don't know, it's just you need somebody to play with. Like I know, like being that you're working and then I get home from coaching or whatever it is that I'm doing and I have like an hour to play something, just kind of relax. I like a single player game where I don't have to rely on somebody else to play with me for it to be fun. Like I also enjoy Call of Duty, but it's not fun unless I have a friend or one of you guys to play with. So I don't like having that hindrance on a game.
That's fair.
Fair.
But I mean, it doesn't matter. Smash
moves forward. On because it's a classic. All right. So Smash
everything that guy
on.
Just said is bullshit. No, shout out to our previous episode.
My cousin Vinny. Okay. So then this next matchup is, you put in Pokemon Red, but that's more. Now we'd say it's going to kind of be just like Pokemon as a franchise, as a, like
I guess
all
so.
The game. Well, not. Well, the beginning games we enjoy more because they came out when we were younger and there was like the OG. But, you know, it's pretty much the same going forward. But
with that, I don't want to add in Sword and Shield because it was trash. So I don't want to put – I want it to be just singular Pokemon Red.
Yeah, I'm fine with that, we could say, because it's OG. It's Red and Blue. And then
same
yellow.
Thing goes for you on because I'm assuming Ratchet and Clank is yours.
Yes, Ratchet and Clank is my number two, but I also do want to say it's more the franchise because the first game looking like after you played like a lot of other games where they had like a lot of more cool weapons and different like upgrades and different suits and things you wore, the original game seems kind of basic compared to the, so I'm kind of more doing it like the franchise of Ratchet and Clank, which the new one's coming out or just came out for PS5, which I want to play and get, but I don't have PS5 yet because the graphics looks amazing. And it's also just love that kind of game, single player fun game. All right, but Kev, take away with Pokemon, which or right. not much things need to be said about it.
No, I mean Pokemon is the best. I think one of the best video game franchises out there. It came out in 1998 for us here in the United States. It came out in 1996 in Japan, and it was called Pokemon Monster or Pocket Monsters.
Pocket Monsters,
And then they changed the name to Pokemon. But
shorten monsters, smash them together.
Yeah, the show actually came out first. That Pokemon anime show came out first. I know we used to watch that all the time on Saturday mornings. But Pokemon Red is one of my favorite games ever. Like I still to this day wish I had a Game Boy so I could play Pokemon Red again. I've played Leaf Green and Fire Red, which is the remakes of it, but I want to play the original.
I'm sure you could find a Game Boy somewhere.
But then to buy, because we don't own Pokemon Red anymore, it broke. I remember when it broke, it wouldn't save anymore.
That's when Kev's like, life ended.
That's where my happiness
started. You restarted over every time.
Yeah, and it was, so I've played emulators like on the laptop. I didn't do it on my laptop. I have an older laptop that I did it on just in case, any bugs came with it. But just the original Pokemon has the original 150, just the sprites, that are in the game, the gameplay. It's so nostalgic, but also it's a simple great game. It's simple. It's an RPG, but you're like building your, catching Pokemon and, everything that came after it, I also enjoy Pokemon Silver as well.
Yeah,
it's like my
Silver's
next
good.
I loved just
I think when we played, we would always get opposite colors. Like you got red, I think I got blue because I remember the Blastoises on that
cartridge. I have the charger,
and I think, and then we had yellow, we got yellow as well, I think after that.
Yeah,
and then when you got silver, I got gold because I've never seen the gold guy. Yep. The
Ho-Oh,
is that was his name? Ho-Oh. Yeah. Yeah, but we got both ones, both like alternating throughout history.
And those are like my favorites. Obviously it's because we were kids at that point, but I still, even like every now and again, I'll get like a little like inkling to be like, I kind of want to play Pokemon Red, but I don't have the ability to do it anymore.
Well, you guys were playing Pokemon on the original Game Boy Colors, and I was too busy like shitting my pants and diapers and stuff like
yeah.
that.
Yeah. Well, I remember playing Game Boy in the car. And like, we would go to like a, you know, a relative's house for like whatever, and we would only play in the car, and we'd leave it in the car, and then we'd play it on the way there, and then on the way back, you know, there's no light on the original.
Gotta have that little
coil. But even before we didn't have that, yeah, this, you know, we have like, you play and like you try to like hold it near the window, and then like every time we'd go underneath a street light, you'd be able to see, and like and you just keep going.
The struggle was real.
I mean,
but yeah, when you guys were doing that, I had like the huge, the big ass gray
original
one.
The original Game Boy.
Yeah, and I was played Tetris on that.
I love that. Tetris could be in this list too. It's a great game.
But so Pokemon, I think
top selling game of all time.
What is the best like franchise of a game because of the fan base? I mean, everyone knows
right now.
Pokemon.
Right now, Pokemon cards are back. They stopped selling them in store in Walmart and Target because people were like, are getting into fights about it.
Yeah,
about so fights over the Pokemon.
That's kind of sad.
Yeah. All trading cards are hot right now. Sports cards, everything is like,
it's
trading
crazy.
Cards become like big again, which I'm like,
I wonder why that is.
Crazy. I don't know. Like I think the market with NFTs and all those different things, like things, bubbled up again.
Yeah, so I think the original Pokemon is so like,
it's OG. It's so good.
Everybody knows like Pikachu. Everybody knows Charmander. Like, if you even like people who've never even played Pokemon know
who those
characters are.
Our mothers know who that is.
Right. So it's, you know, I think it's just in pop culture, but it's also just an amazing game that will be amazing throughout, even though the newest Pokemon was terrible.
Everybody knows like at least Pikachu. Like all the boomers call Pokemon Pikachu. Like they call, oh, is that you playing Pikachu over there? No.
The Pokemans?
Pokemans.
Yeah.
All right, so Ratchet and Clank, what do you got? See if it could be
against Pokemon. It's not as OG as Pokemon, but it's pretty OG. It came out in 2002 on the PlayStation 2, and then beyond. Obviously, I'm talking about the whole franchise. So then there was like I'm not sure all of them. I don't remember all of them. I remember playing all of them, but not like there's a lot of like mobile ones too, like for the PSP and the PlayStation Vita and all these different things that I didn't really have or didn't play, but like all the major console ones, like so like two PS3, PS4, and then they remade in 2016, they remade the original one from 2002 again on the PS4, which I did play through recently, and it was a lot of fun. But it was like very simple compared to what the games became later, because there was not as many like guns and upgrades and things.
Yeah. What I just remember the guy Captain Quark. Is that the original one?
Yeah, Captain Quark is the original one, but he was like the hero that then turned out to be a scumbag and like just kind of a very selfish jerk.
Yeah. Somebody is driving by.
Oh, it sounds nice.
Blasting. Why are you sound like you're in my living room? Good Lord. You're like blasting Lady Gaga right on my front lawn.
Happy Pride.
I say it's Pride Month. Hell yeah.
All right. Well,
that's fine.
Sorry, listeners. You got Lady Gaga going in the background.
Not complaining. All right. But just Ratchet and Clank. I just love that kind of game, a single player adventure where you unlock and you get different kind of guns and outfits and different things. And then they slowly can get it upgraded. That kind of grind to upgrade your weapons is just something like I love in any kind of game. Where like, and you get like new abilities, you get new things, you know, and it's also a fun sci-fi story where you're this imaginary fox rat called a Lombax, and you have a little backpack robot friend, and it's just a lot of fun. And I've played it since the OG 2002 game. And I just have, every time a new one's coming out, I'm like, ooh, even though it's like simple, you know, more for kids. Now I'm a 30-year-old man. I could, you know, I have taxes to do and things. I don't have time to do that, but I still find time to play these old games I've been playing for years. It's just a good time. I enjoy every time.
I love
my favorite part of that game is the magnetic boots where you can walk on stuff.
There's so many fun inventive weapons and like different outfits and things to get that just like make gameplay just such a good time.
What was the currency in that game? Like the bolts?
It was the bolts.
It was like screws and bolts or something.
Because
like
his thing is like he carries a wrench and that's his like melee, and he pretty much like breaks open the crates and then the bolts just suck into you somehow. I don't know, but it's a great time.
I love the I forget what it's called, like it's up your arsenal, is that the one?
Oh, yeah, that's where you're pretty much in like a,
you're captured and you're doing
like
Hunger
Games,
like the
Hunger
Games
thing.
Type. That one was awesome. You got like these cool suits upgraded,
like the suits that could be upgraded were a lot of fun and a lot of different things, because compared to the original one, you purchase, get a couple cool guns and the magnetic boots, and that's about it. But like when they
grind boots, when you would like grind around
on the rails. just a lot of just all over fun that just for all.
Yeah. The concept was really cool because you could use your spaceship and fly to different planets and stuff like that. Yeah, it's just different worlds. It was cool.
Always will enjoy and always will enjoy. But going as Pokemon is kind of a worldwide phenomenon.
Yeah, that's tough. That's a tough matchup. So I mean, my vote is same with Pokemon is just so iconic in many ways. I mean,
I may switch my vote as well because I. With this matchup, I do love Ratchet and Clank to death. It's like I'll always play the game for forever. But Pokemon was such a huge thing and still is a huge thing. I'm excited for the remake of the Pearl and Diamond, I think, is the remake is coming out, which I'm excited for that because Sword Shield was a little too open worldy where I'm like, it doesn't feel the same. I like the top down, walk around, get the Pokemon in the grass. Yeah.
And the story was bad.
Yeah, the story was lame. But also, like, I don't like to see the Pokemon. When you're out in that like wild area in Sword and Shield, where you can like walk around and see the Pokemon. Like, I want to be surprised when they're in the grass, and then like, ooh, you got like, ooh, what is it? And then you see it. Seeing the Pokemon was like, okay, I need that one. I'm gonna walk over and just like ram into it, and I'll catch it. It's not the same essence. But Pokemon is my vote because it's just a lot of fun forever.
All right, Bri.
Well, it doesn't matter, but I'm gonna go with Ratchet and Clank. I never really played the Pokemon games, to be honest.
That was more like he said.
I liked the cards, and I liked watching the show, but I never really got into the game of it.
Oh wow!
So, but I was definitely into Ratchet and Clank. That was a great game. So,
all right.
It's not gonna move on, but that one gets my vote for sure.
That's all right. You know, I remember. You know, Dad would drive us around to different places to try to find Pokemon cards when it was first the first big thing. We went to a couple of stores, no, and then we went to this one comic shop and they had packs. And Dad would bring us like random packs from the city. Sometimes there'd probably some guy on the sidewalk selling packs, and Dad would buy us two.
Yeah.
And then I got a holographic Blastoise that one time, and Kev was livid.
You always got better cards than me. It was terrible. Well,
it was all random. Dad was like, okay,
it's all random, but you always got better cards, even with Yu-Gi-Oh too.
I can't help it, man. I got that luck. Yeah. All right, so Pokemon moves on, not surprisingly. And then next up is my number one pick.
That's your number one. All right.
Wow.
Yeah, my number one pick. Spider-Man PS4 versus, I think you're Kev.
This is my number three.
Number three, League of Legends. So do you want to start with League of Legends first or me go Spider-Man?
Sure, I'll go League of Legends first. So, like, I don't know, neither one of you played League before, right?
No, I've seen people play it, but I've never played it. My biggest extent is just
watching you play it is the only experience I have.
League of Legends is so big around the world.
It's huge,
It's incredible. They're currently, I looked this up before we started, there are currently 115 million players playing actively League of Legends.
Like right this second?
Not right this second, but just like, you know, collectively.
That's an average.
Yeah, it's average. There's also leagues and like
there's leagues of leagues of
play.
Yes, leagues of leagues of legend.
Yes, you can make a team and like play in a league like you would a rec volleyball league or something. You can play League of Legends. There's pro leagues and like esports. Esports pretty much started and surrounded by crazy. League of Legends.
They're like stadiums. Really? Yes. Stadiums
full of people to watch these things. Winning team of League of Legends, like there's five on a team. Each made like a couple million dollars when they won the trophy.
It's crazy.
Yeah,
esports is like enormous.
It's nuts.
Especially overseas, like in Korea, that kind of like esports is like watching the Super Bowl for
people. More people watched the League of Legends championship last year than they watched the World Series.
Which is fair. I didn't watch the World Series either.
Nobody likes baseball, but.
Shout out to the baseball lovers.
League of Legends is like a phenomenal thing game as like a whole, but even just like as a game, it's so much fun to play with people. When you get a team of people, there's 140 different types of characters that you can pick between. There's so many options of who you want to play as, and unlike Super Smash where there's a lot of characters, they all pretty much have the same combat style. Like, you know, you got a heavy attack, you got a special attack. But with League, each champion is so different. in a sense of that each player has like a role to play. So you're either like a damage player, a support, so you're going to like help heal the damage person. You have a bruiser who's like a top, who like can do some damage, but also is kind of like has a lot of health. Damage. Yeah, and you have like a stealthy guy who then goes around and tries to help out all the people. So they need to be have a lot of health, but also be kind of stealthy. Either they have a lot of health and they can move quickly, or they have a little amount of health, do a lot of damage, but they're like quick and fast. And like, so you find what you like to play, and then you're just really good with that, and you just kind of work with that. Like, we played this game so much in college. This was our thing, because we had a quad.
That was your Super Smash Brothers in college.
Basically. So we had, but we wouldn't see like the difference between you playing Super Smash with your college roommates and me playing League is that you're playing against each other.
Yeah.
We were always playing with each other on the same team. So we would have, there's four people in my room, and our friend Bill would always come and join us because there's five people on a team in League. And you would all work together to beat another team. So like we were all working collaboratively, and we all like found our roles and stuck with it. Like Kyle, when my old roommate Shadow Kyle, he was an amazing jungler. So he would always be like that stealthy guy who would go and help everybody else out. And he was so good at it. So like, and I would always be a great support. So I would always heal and help Zoro, who would be then shout out Zoro, my roommate from college. He would always do all the damage. So like we just all fit in our roles, and we played that game so much. And still to this day, we'll call each other up and be like, yo, you want to play? Like I play with my other roommate Colton all the time, and we do things that are not like the way the game is supposed to be played, which is called meta. We do things that don't make sense, but they work, and we have a lot of fun with it. And we're always just like talking on the phone while we're playing, and it's just something that we still to this day play. And the game is just it's
massive.
Yeah. Type of phenom.
Kind of reminds me of Overwatch a little bit.
Yeah, a little bit.
I'm sure that came first.
It's a different kind of gameplay, but like the team thing is similar.
Yeah,
team
like comp the different is roles similar. And the different kinds of players.
But
yeah.
League of Legends, there's like three lanes.
Is there bases? And,
yeah, you have your base, and then there's three lanes.
I've seen gameplay here.
And you have to, like, there's towers that protect your base, and you have to destroy the other team's towers and to then destroy their base, and they're trying to do the same thing to you. So it's kind of like a tower defense and attack
at the same time.
Yeah, it's a really great strategic game with a lot of awesome like gameplay to like help each other out, especially if you have like some people that like to play with you.
Cool.
I've never played it, but you sold the game for me. I think I would like to play it.
It's amazing.
Well, this that kind of not that reminds me of, but like I'm thinking of like we don't have in this list, but it definitely could have been added anywhere. Any kind of Diablo 2 or something like a Diablo, like where. Playing with each other is fun, where you like you have your class and you do your you go through the dungeons together, blah blah blah.
Yeah,
but that's not on the list, so we're not going to talk about it. But it definitely honorable mention for sure.
Hey, that's a good word.
All right, so I'm going to jump up to then Spider-Man. The matchup for Spider-Man PS4, the newer Spider-Man, not the Miles Morales one, even though that one's fun and a good time. I'm talking about the one that like kind of started this whole new Spider-Man era on PlayStation. PlayStation exclusive for sure, because they wanted to lock that down. 2018 came out, so pretty recent. I played this game so hard when it came out, and I was so excited for it because they had Spider-Man 2 game. I think that was on PS2 or 3.
I think PS3. I love that game.
By the way, you can like just the free swinging around.
That's all I did for most of those games.
You just swing around. You have so much fun, and it felt like it was like the swinging feels good. In the PlayStation Spider-Man 2 game, but then even obviously more with the graphics looking so much better in the newer Spider-Man game. And the story is actually really good. You know, it's a good time. The story is great if you're like, if you're a Spider-Man fan or comic fan. And there's just the swinging just feels so good. Combat's fun. The web swinging, like just like webbing up enemies, different things, swinging them around, shooting a giant web ball at them. They hit, stick against the wall, like. And I'm just a huge Spider-Man fan, so like anytime anything Spider-Man comes out, I'm excited for it. So
Will's got the new Spider-Man toothbrush. came out.
anything like Spider-Man, just it's so much fun, and just because I like one of my favorite superheroes, so like then be able to play as him and like play well, like I mean, it's like a fun, like well done game, and I'm excited to eventually get a PS5 and then play it on that and like turn ray tracing on and reflections, so you can like go to a like go swing up on like a glass building and see your reflection and see like the reflection of the city behind you in it. The graphics look crazy in the new Miles Morales game, yeah, for sure.
And the controller with the haptic feedback and everything on the swinging stuff is supposed to be amazing.
Please, if Sony, if you're listening, I beg of you, please, at least just send me a PS5.
Excuse me?
If you only can do one, just send it to me.
Why would it go to you?
I don't know, because I'm asking.
He got you there.
It's just a lot of fun, and I could, you know, I'll replay the game here and there just to swing around and have a good time.
I've played this game. I played through once, I believe. I think this was before Kev, before you moved out, because you took the PlayStation with you. It was yours.
Took the PlayStation, my PlayStation. I bought it.
You son of a bitch.
Yeah.
You're lucky I let you play it.
You're right. But yeah, I played through this once. It was pretty good. My favorite part was just swinging around, just like the same thing with what I did with the PlayStation 2 one of the Spider-Man 2. Shout out Tobey Maguire.
If you're listening, Tobey.
Yeah, Tobey. I know he is. I don't think I finished the story all the way. I must have. But I spent most of my time just swinging around and just if anyone was like, help, I'd be like, I got you. And then Spider-Man would come to the rescue. That's pretty much how I play the entire game, just to swing around and have some fun.
All right. So if we're going to go to the voting, my voting stays the same.
That's fair.
Because, I played it for a little bit, the Spider-Man game, and the gameplay was fun, and like I liked swinging around, but I didn't like it enough to continue with it. I don't know. I got like maybe halfway through.
The story gets even better at the end. It's really good.
So I have to give it another shot, but it's just like I just kind of was like, man, it's cool.
It's not for everybody, but I just have a special – Spider-Man has a special place in my heart.
That's fair.
So obviously my vote's staying, so Bride, decide
the fate. So I liked Kev's point about – what'd you say again?
I like this point.
I said
about,
a lot.
That's
it's cooperative.
No, something you just said like 10 seconds ago, but whatever. I liked what you said about it just slipped my mind. I don't know.
Well, obviously it was really convincing.
You liked it, but you don't remember what you liked.
Oh, yeah. So I liked the Spider-Man. I liked the game itself. The gameplay was really cool. I did finish the story, but after I finished it, I was like, sweet, I finished the game. I have never played League of Legends before, but based on that description and what I know about it and what I've heard about it and like games that I've played that have been similar to it, I could definitely play that game for hours at a time and continue to do so for a long period of time. Like the game Overwatch that I brought up before, I played that for a long time. And the description kind of reminded me of that. So I'm going to give my vote to League of Legends.
Wow.
It's definitely a game.
You're gonna give it to a game he hasn't even played?
I just am that convincing. Style,
this dude, is bullshit.
The style of game, I can see myself.
Yeah, well, it's a game as a service thing where like you always are incentivized to play more and play. But I'm always a fan with a single player game where like I could play it to its completion, then put it away, and then start a new single player. I'm pretty much doing that. I'm playing Biomutant right now, and I'm playing through that.
Like, I'm a fan of those games as well.
Yeah, it's the new one that just came out.
Is it good?
It could be good if they like took out like two or three systems from the game. They had all these ideas of like there's like a layers of light in the dark system, like you do good or you do bad. There's a tribe system where you have to join a tribe and then you defend it or like align with a different tribe. Then there's just too many things in one. Like if they just focus on like one avenue of that, it would be much more focused and fun. It's still fun. And, like,
I've never heard of this game before.
It just came out.
You're like a little squirrel. It's like a post-apocalyptic game where like everyone's dead except these like little critters that kind of like
think mutated Ratchet from Ratchet and Clank.
Yeah, mutated Ratchet from Ratchet and Clank, but then it's also like Breath of the Wild, where there's like you explore the world and stuff, and there's a lot of like loot to pick up, and then you like you know
what's this called again?
Biomutant.
It's fun. I wouldn't put it on the list for sure, but it's definitely if I'm playing, it's fun.
So Bri, League of Legends, it's on the laptop. Download it. It's free. I think that's another thing I didn't even mention. League of Legends is free. The only thing you could pay for like each character, you can get different skins for them. So like they can have like one, you know, one that I've gotten in the past when I in college, I would actually spend real money on it because I was just that into it at the time. My username is a Roman general. Like, it, I'm not going to give my username out, but it is a Roman general from Roman history. So there's a lot of different characters that have gladiator or Roman skins. So I have like Draven is a cool character, and he has a gladiator skin. So I have that skin for him. So it's like, obviously with my Roman history username, I have a gladiator skin for him, but that's the only thing. And it doesn't change gameplay at all. It's just your guy looks really cool. The game is completely free.
Start a Brothers Thrice League of Legends.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do it up. I mean, you guys will be really bad to start because it's a game that has a hard learning curve. But once you get into it and you understand how it works, you just get better and better, and it's a lot of fun. So it moves on.
I don't know if my laptop can handle any more games. I have quite a few downloaded on here, but
well, just don't run them at the same time.
Yeah.
Well, duh.
If it can run Skyrim on your laptop, you can run
I think it's not as gate.
And you can just turn the graphics all the way down. I mean, the graphics aren't like, you know,
anything
something like play the game
16 bits.
All right. Yeah. Moving on, next bracket.
Ooh, this is a tough one.
You really shafted me with this one because these are both mine.
How am I supposed? I just put them in. I did the best.
Will's fault.
I put them in as best. Well, I can move them. I could have moved them around, but I thought this was a decent layout. Like, there's not gonna be any ones that are gonna be like good easy matchups. You want it to be
no, but those are both his.
Well, that's just the way it works out sometimes. Because it's three of us. Like one of us will definitely
two and three.
One of us will definitely have our own.
No, my one and two actually.
We'll definitely have our one and two against each other. It's just how it worked out. There's three of us. Well, it's going to match up like that eventually. Well, it makes it
hard.
It's up to our votes, though, Bryce.
Let's tell the listeners what the matchup is.
It's Assassin's Creed 2. Is that the whole series or is this just two?
No, just two.
All right. Fair with that.
Not the whole series, just two.
And then also Mario Super Brothers, Super Mario Brothers 3. Just
met Mario Super Brothers.
Mario Super Brothers. Super Mario Super Brother. Jesus Christ. Super Mario Brothers 3. Just the game?
Yes.
Not the. I guess it's hard to do Mario as a whole because it's like they have a million properties.
It's too much.
A trillion of them. Yeah. Just
okay. Before you go into yours, now that we're talking about Super Mario, I was talking to Dad yesterday about. It was like, oh yeah, we're going to do video games. And he's like, you guys going to talk about Donkey Kong, right?
Pac-Man.
No, Dad. We're not going to talk about your. It's our video games, not your video games. We got to talk about. You got to talk about Donkey Kong. I'm like, why would we talk about Donkey Kong? So we're just going back and forth. Yeah, and that's exactly what I was like. I started doing the sound effects, and he's like, Brian's probably going to do those sound effects.
It's a classic, but it's not. It doesn't hold up now because it's so simple.
One of those like he's like.
When we were talking about this. Matt, like these this bracket, we brought up Dig Dug too. Like, very classic game, but it's not gonna, you know, it's not gonna make the bracket.
Because that's a game you can play for like 15 minutes. You're like, okay, I'm good for a good year.
Yeah, I mean now, but like back in the day, that was
on the PC. That's all we had.
I also
that in like, solitaire.
Honorable mention.
The pinball game.
Oh, the pinball game was good.
Honorable mention. Sonic the Hedgehog on Sega.
There's too many good classic ones to pick. Like, there's just not enough room in the bracket.
And also, shout out to that game's music because Sonic's music was the best music for video games ever.
Like we were talking about this last time. The music that when you're under the water and you're about to run out of breath, it gives me a heart attack every time.
That music is what anxiety feels like to people who have anxiety.
If you're having an anxiety attack, you hear that in your head.
Yeah,
for sure. That's I think that's what they meant to happen. You're like, get out of the water 100%. Right now! Get out of the water!
Oh, such a great game.
All right, well, back to this matchup: Assassin's Creed 2 versus Super Mario Brothers 3. Bri, take us through.
The fact that these are pinned up against each other, like I feel like I'm, like I feel like I can't maybe one.
I feel like I'm a crazy person.
I can't think of what the movie is, but like imagine like. I feel like I have to pick which one of my children I have to save.
Sophie's
from
Choice
ledge.
Is what you're going for there, right?
That's the one. That's the one.
Well, but also, like, right, it's not all on you. Like, it's also going to come to us, so don't worry.
I know,
but
still, to pin these against each other, I feel like both two of my children are hanging off of a cliff, and I can only save one of them.
Well, then we'll save the other one. Don't worry.
Okay, thanks. Well, no, that's not how the bracket works, but okay.
Well, no, but like, the reason the other child falls won't be your fault. It won't be on your conscience.
They're still dying, though.
Well... They'll be okay.
Don't worry about your imaginary kids. We're talking about video games.
Anyway.
So Assassin's Creed 2.
I'll start with Assassin's Creed 2. This is going to be so hard. Anyway, Assassin's Creed 2.
Like me with movies.
Just talking about both of these is going to be so difficult. But Assassin's Creed 2 was my number one. This is my number one on the list. I played this game from beginning to end at least 20 times, and that's not an exaggeration. Yeah. I made a save. I played it through. Time has passed. Played through again. And I named them. So just a little background. Assassin's Creed 2 is part of the Assassin's Creed series game, obviously. And this one takes place in Renaissance Italy back in the 14th. Yes, back in 1490s, I believe it began, something like that.
1492?
With your boy Ezio Auditore.
I only know that from you guys saying it constantly.
Yeah.
Ezio Auditore.
So he's from Florence, Italy, and he starts out as a young boy, and then he's thrust into the life of an assassin due to the murder of his father and brothers.
But this also has to do with, like, the guy in the future. It's like the guy's ancestor.
Yes. So that part
was always like, what? Why do you have an extra stuff?
Well, the whole premise is that this machine in present day can use the DNA. Your DNA
to see your ancestors'
memories, because your ancestors live inside your DNA, so they use that to see different aspects of history. Of course, it's not true. It's a video game, but the concept of it was super cool. Out.
No, that's definitely fun, but it's funny. It's like they live inside your DNA. It's like, no, they don't.
Yeah. No, not them. Like, not their spirits. Their memories. Like, their memories are stored inside the DNA.
It doesn't make scientific sense, but it's still.
I want my
cool
video
premise.
Games to be scientifically accurate only.
Yeah, you love Spider-Man, right? Super scientific.
That's a genetic. That was a radioactive spider that bit him. That's pretty.
Okay, you also put Ratchet and Clank on this list, and it's a.
They're aliens. You don't know what's out. They're aliens. You don't know what's out there. Have you been to other planets, Kev? I don't think so.
If you got bit by a radioactive spider, you would just get. You just lose your hair and
die radiation poisoning. You don't know.
Yeah. Okay, you're right. I don't know. Anyway, so Assassin's Creed is one of those games. and you go through his entire life as Ezio, and you're thrust into the life of an assassin. And it's just a fantastic game. And I feel like I know more about Italian language and culture through that game more than the 5 years of Italian I took in middle school.
I second that.
Well, I'm the only one out of three of us who actually has been to Italy. So
yeah. And we probably know more about Italy because we played that game and you didn't.
I got married there. So whatever.
What does that mean? You know about Italian history?
Yeah, I know.
We probably climbed the buildings that you got married near, and you never climbed them.
I didn't go to Florence, so suck it.
Well, it was not just Florence, okay?
I went to... Okay, go ahead.
Speaking of climbing buildings, this game has influenced my life so much, so that, like, I...
You climb buildings?
No, but I think about it.
Parkour.
I see buildings that look like buildings that you could climb in that game, like older kind of church looking things or older buildings. And I'm like, I could definitely climb that shit.
Yeah. See, like, I would climb up that section and then you got to crawl over that section.
I would push the up button until I was up at the top.
No. See, I think about it like for real. Like I said, okay, I could totally put my foot up on that one, jump up on that and then swing.
Why
over
don't
that.
You do it?
Because I'm not stupid.
I'm also not strong enough.
In the game, when you would climb up a building and there was like a crowd of people walking around, they would always be like, oh, what is he doing? Like, they would always, like, people would be like, oh, you're an idiot. What are you doing up there?
Yeah. So they know.
I'm assassinating people.
That game is, the story behind it is amazing as well.
And do you also see a giant thing of hay or a thing that want to just jump off?
There's a tiny like pile of hay and you can jump 50 stories and just be totally fine. Like,
break every bone in your body. Hay won't do that and it won't do anything for you.
Yeah. The story, like you said, Bri, is I think one of the best stories in all of video games. It's like a. So it's good. If they made it a movie, I feel like it wouldn't be as.
They did
good
make a movie.
No. They made it a movie of like Assassin's Creed, but just a different like thing. But if they made with that story from the from the game,
you guys see that movie?
I did. Yeah, it was bad.
It was. I heard it was bad.
Yeah, it was bad. Yeah. No, but they took it in a different way.
Yeah, if they made a movie like
it took like the just Assassin's Creed like idea and just did their
and made it But like Ezio Auditore da Firenze is the coolest character in all of video games. He's just so suave. Like me and Brian, I'm pretty sure can quote that the video game from start to finish.
Yeah,
like all
the cutscenes. Like don't. it feels like a movie. It's just so it good.
Like the beginning, Brian, when he gets in the fight and he's got like he gets hit with a rock, so he's got like a cut. He's like, "Oh, you got to go to the doctor. I don't have any florins. Wasted it on women and wine, have you?
I'd hardly call it wasting."
Jesus Christ.
Lend me some florins then. Or have you done the same?
Jesus Christ. I gotta go.
Oh, it's just such a great game.
So good.
Me and Kev bond on Pokemon. You guys bond on Assassin's Creed. I'll just sit here.
Yeah. Oh, it's so good.
But shout out to another game that did not make my list, but was very close to doing. You're talking about like story being amazing. Last of Us. The original Last of Us story-wise was just so good. The relationships in the game, like it's a game, and like yet you like feel for every single character really well. Yeah. Almost
I watched
made my
a playthrough about.
Just almost made my list, but just didn't sneak in because of nostalgia factors for the other ones. But solid story as well.
I watched a streamer play through that, and the story was really good.
Yeah,
the second one I enjoyed too, but
I haven't played the second one.
It was good. All right, so
I guess we should move on to Super Mario Brothers.
No, Super Mario Brothers.
Sorry.
Super Mario Brothers, Super Smash Mario, Super Mario Brothers.
Three. This was Game Boy?
This is on the Game Boy Advance.
Mm-hmm. This is originally NES.
Yes, yep. Originally NES, but that. I had it on the Game Boy Advance. I was just playing it this morning to kind of rev up to this. It's available on the Switch, and I love it as much as I did when I was like 12. No, way younger than that.
It was released in 1990. Shout out 1990. Boop, boop. My birth year. Came out NES 1990. But then when I guess it was then re-put out or whatever for Game Boy Advance back, on the...
Yes. And I played this game so much. And it's one of those games where like you can play the same level 1,000 times and lose every single time. You're like, "God, son of a bitch, I can get this one. I can get this time. I get it. And then do it like over and over and over again until you finally get it. And then the euphoria that you feel.
Or you just
finally get
throw
the past
machine.
The level.
Or you can just, you do it until you get it, or you just can't get it. And you're like, "I have to walk away for like a couple hours and maybe come back to it because I can't."
I love the different things you can get. Like, regular Mario, you get the mushroom and you get bigger, right? I love the, you can get the little leaf and turn into a raccoon that like flies. Yeah.
It's actually a tanuki. Frog.
Oh,
come
shit.
On, Kev.
A tanuki?
Yeah. It's actually Tanuki Mario. Look it up.
Okay. It's a
raccoon. Read a book, Kev.
Or you get the little frog one and you can swim. Mm-hmm. And then like the one with the hat and you turn to like you can throw fireballs.
Yeah, the flower one. Yeah. That game is the like a classic Mario platform game with the Goombas and the Turtles and a simple game of course, but I played that game an insane amount of hours on that Game Boy.
So it's always good to come back to because like you don't have to like there's not deep story to it. It's just a fun game.
Yeah.
You just jump in whenever you want at any point and just continue to enjoy.
So good. To put it up against this other game is...
Well, I know where I'm going just because of...
I know where I'm going.
But also, I don't know where you guys are because it seems like... tell me some Mario quotes for Mario Brothers. It's a me, Mario!
Which is also a quote in Assassin's Creed 2.
Yes,
you go and you meet his uncle. And
he says, it's a me, Mario?
Yes, he's Uncle Mario. And he goes... Uncle? He goes, "It's a me, Mario."
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Obviously, that's just a nod to the game.
Obviously, probably. But it's just great.
He's like, you don't remember? It's a me, Mario. Yeah.
And it's like this old, like scarred up dude with a beard. And he's like, Mario.
That's Mario later on in his life.
Yeah.
So
Peach divorced him.
Oh, that's sad.
All right, so I'm going Super Mario Bros. Just because of I don't have the same connection as Assassin's Creed.
I'm going Assassin's Creed. So, Bri, you have to vote to see which one moves forward.
Kill your child.
Remember when we said we were going to help you? No, we're not. You just have to make one fall off the
kill cliff. Your child, son.
This is so hard.
Well, just hearing the arguments or whatever, it seems like you have much more love for Assassin's Creed more than you have for Mario Brothers. Not saying you don't not like Mario Brothers. I just think Brian had more of a love for like just the whole world of Assassin's Creed, if that's helping your decision.
I mean, Brian, we still handshake the way they do in Assassin's Creed and say, Insieme per Victoria. So,
yeah,
I mean, true.
And that's just something we just do subconsciously. Like, we'll see each other.
Everyone's listening is just like, God, such Italian nerds.
Well, we're doing a podcast about video games, Will. How much more nerdy can we
get? I guess that's true. But you guys yeah. took it to another level when you're quoting the game.
Well, you know, if you played this game, you would do the same.
Yeah.
I'm going with Assassin's Creed 2. You can't beat Ezio as a character. And it hurts me.
Mario will be classic in OG forever. He's wearing the Tanuki suit. He'll fly away. He won't die.
He's fine.
True. Yeah. Oh yeah. So I can drop him off the cliff and he'll just go. Broop, 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 away.
All right. That's our first that's our first solid round. So we'll go to a quick commercial break and come right back and then finish off this bracket hardcore.
Hardcore.
All right. Be right back. Brothers Thrice. And we're back. Time to finish off this list, this brackets. So now we gotta go all the way back up to the top. And since Super Smash Brothers won the matchup, right? Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. For a second, I was like, did it? But yes, it did. It's going against, I'm guessing it's Kev's number one.
My number one.
Which I know is also
Elder Scrolls 5 Skyrim.
This was going to be on my list as well. Probably going to be my number one as well. But then I knew it was going to be a duplicate because, again, I was late on my submissions. I'm busy. And Will was like, nope, taken. And I was like, okay, I knew I had
to. Well, you assumed that you knew it was going to be.
Yeah.
Because you guys don't stop talking about this freaking game.
This game.
And it's also old as hell.
It came out in 2011.
It's 10 years old. It's a decade old game.
It's a decade old.
It looks like
it's still going
duty.
Strong. Still, it does not look like Duty.
It looks like Duty. Have you seen newer games? They look amazing. That looks like
doesn't
Duty.
Doesn't matter.
It's going to look worse than newer games.
It's
10 That's how
years
graphics
old.
Work.
This
but
game
it doesn't look good.
It has been ported to every single avenue in which gaming can be done. It's been ported to and sold well.
On the phone?
It was on the PlayStation 3.
Mobile game?
Yes, they have a mobile game for Skyrim.
Oh, shit. I was joking. Wow.
That's how they do. It's called Blades.
Backfired.
Take that. It was on PlayStation 3 originally in 2011 and also came out for the PC then. It is
Did it come out for the Xbox too?
It was on Xbox.
Xbox
360. It was on Xbox One. It was on PlayStation 4. It was on the Switch. It's even on Alexa. If you're listening out loud and you have an Alexa, say, Alexa, play Skyrim. It will go and you can play Skyrim.
How
kinda
do
like
you
a joke. It's a joke, but like it actually works on your Alexa. This game is so huge. There's over 225 hours of gameplay in this game. So you can start a game and you will literally never finish it because 225 hours of gameplay is just an absurd amount.
Well, that means you'll finish it eventually. It just takes a while.
Yeah, but like you won't though because like you just there's
so
many different skills
and stuff to do
that you can level up. Like there's so many different, like there's over 20 different skills that you level up and you can get it to 99 or 100 as like the cap. Mm-hmm. And there's like, even just, it's not just like, oh, let me level up my magic skills. There's destruction magic, restoration magic, illusion magic, conjuring magic. There are different types of spells. And not to mention, they allowed this game to be modded where people have created other content to come onto this game. So this 225 hours is the base game.
Yeah.
Not to mention the DLCs that they also added. There's like five DLCs.
When are they releasing a new one? I thought that was like a big
Elder Scrolls 6 is still in I'd say 2025 is when that's going to come out. Because that game's going to be huge and massive and like I'm probably going to have like three kids and like, you know, live it somewhere else when I have that kid. No, it's not coming out in 2025. That's like the preliminary. It's not coming out then. It's going to be delayed because this game's going to be huge. But Skyrim is so good. I've played it so long, so many hours. Every single person you talk to in the game, every NPC gives you a quest. like it, you can just walk in the woods, find a shack. There's like some old lady there. She'll ask you to do something for her. You'll get something for it. Like
or everybody has,
or she'll attack you, which the like Agnes's hut in Skyrim, she's just like an old woman. If you accidentally hit her or steal one of her things, she's like a mastery level wizard and will just destroy you.
There's a basement in her little hut. If you sneak into her house and then go into that basement, she's got like these alchemy tables and enchanting tables. I'm pretty sure there's some dead bodies in there. She's a crazy lady. So
yeah, and this amount of hours that this game allows you to play, but also just customizing, there's different ways to play it. Like you could play it as an archer, you can play it as a mage, you can play it as different types of mage, you can do a sword, you can do a two-handed sword, sword and shield. Like you can play it over and over again and also customize your person. There's like seven different races. You can make whatever you want. They each have different skills. So this game, the replay value on it is incredible. I mean, I have it for the PlayStation 3, the PlayStation 4, the PC, and the Switch.
That's how long it's been out.
Yes, but that's how many times I've played it. Yeah. And all you know, this me and my roommate Zorro have played it when we were in college together. Like we were just like go back and forth playing the same character. And they're like we have just stories that we always talk about even to this day. Like there's a character you can get. You do a quest for him, he follows you and helps you out. His name's Faendal. He's just like, you know, a guy who will follow you around and like fight with you and have your back.
This is another one. I'm like, okay.
Yeah. But we went to this random castle and there was just like bandits in it. You kill all the bandits. And then there's this old woman. Her name was, I think, Angie or something. She's just like,
Angie.
She's just brooming, you know, sweeping up the floor. And she's like, oh, I've lived in this castle for so many years. And I just help clean up after whoever lives here, whether it be bandits or knights or whatever. And she's like a sweet old lady. We're like, oh, look at, I think her name was Agnes. Like, oh, look at Agnes over here. And then there was a sweet roll on the counter. So we just took this sweet roll and it said steal. And it's like, oh, like I stole her sweet roll. Then 3 or 4 hours later in the game, we're playing and mercenaries came and attacked us. We killed the mercenaries and we noticed Faendal was gone. We're like, what? We go to Faendal's house. There was 2 dead mercenaries and Faendal dead. And we're like, these mercenaries came after Faendal. We searched the bodies of the mercenaries that killed Faendal. There was a contract and said, I don't care what it takes. Take this person out. Signed Agnes. Agnes sent mercenaries to kill us for stealing her sweet roll. That and like just stuff like that happens in the game all the time. So we went back. We killed Agnes. We trapped her soul in a gem and enchanted Faendal's bow with her soul and named it the Wrath of Faendal. And we hung it over our mantle.
I didn't know you did that. I heard that song before, but I didn't know you did that with your soul.
Yeah, you can trap creatures' souls in gems. So we killed her and put her soul in a gem and then enchanted a bow with it.
Jesus.
We took Faendal's bow and we enchanted it with her soul. So her soul is trapped in Faendal's bow because that's what she gets.
The poetic justice.
That's right. And we named it the Wrath of Faendal and we hung it over. So just stuff like that you could do throughout the entire game for 225 hours of gameplay.
At least.
At a minimum.
So that's my statement. This matchup is tough, though. This matchup is a tough matchup.
It sounds like it's not a tough matchup.
Not for me, it's not.
I'm thinking about it. It's hard going up against Super Smash Brothers. Like, I don't know.
Well, what do you think? My vote is Super Smash just because I've played Skyrim like once with you guys or like when we had it on whatever was at home, and I played it and I was like, okay, and I kind of just like kind of I think it was before I was more into longer term video games, but I also don't like to read video games at all, like at all ever.
Read in Skyrim.
You just said you had to read a thing, and it's a contract or something.
No, that's just something you can. Reading novels.
I'm always like, I'm always skipping past dialogue. I don't like talking to people in video games. I always skip through the guy. I like stories.
Well, obviously not, because you're skipping the dialogue.
I don't like to read. I want it just be.
Well, then you just listen. You listen to the dialogue. I don't understand.
Other games don't have it read out. Usually, it's like. Yeah, whatever.
You can turn off the closed captions.
Then you just listen.
No. I'm talking about other games that they don't say the lines out loud. Other games, not saying Skyrim. Other games do that. Where they'll just like
in Skyrim, your character doesn't speak.
Yeah,
Like you click on the sentence that you want them to
that's
say.
That's what you mean.
And the other character speaks.
No, I don't mind dialogue trees. I did that for Cyberpunk. I did that for everything. But I don't like, it's just like when it's too much, like you have to talk to every single person and like every single person has to say something. And you
too much talking. Okay.
Too much talking. Just I'm like, can I just play the game? I don't want to talk to everybody. That's why that's the reason I'm playing video games. So I don't talk to people. I don't want to talk to people in my video games. But I'm voting for Smash just because of the nostalgia and I just don't have the affinity for Skyrim like you guys do.
I'm going Skyrim because
because of the rant Kev just went on.
I could go on for hours. Skyrim, I've been talking about it all the time. And then my wife's brother, so my brother-in-law, he never played it. He has an Xbox 360. And when quarantine happened for COVID, he went and got Skyrim used from GameStop for like $9. And he's like, Kev, I started playing Skyrim because you always said it was good. He's like, it's amazing. Like, I've been playing it nonstop. It's just amazing. I was like, I told you. I told you.
I just wish they updated graphics. I wish it looked better by today's standards.
Well, like, if you get it on like next gen consoles, it does look better.
Yeah, on PS4 it looks better than it did on PlayStation 3.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
They updated it in that sense, but as far as like, I don't know. This one's hard. I played both of these games for
a
great
time.
Many years and a great many hours. But I think I'm gonna have to give it a Skyrim because
that's why I put it as the number one seed because I was like, I don't think this even needs to go up against have anybody for a bye. So I'm like, I'll just put this here because I know you guys will both be fine with that.
Yeah, it deserves it because it's just so good. I would recommend giving it another shot. Well, so
yep. Yeah, maybe we'll see.
We'll see.
All right, so then Skyrim moves on to the quarters. Then now we're doing go down. Yeah, we'll go down to the bottom. We'll come back up.
Yeah.
So now it is
League of Legends against Assassin's Creed.
So it's
God.
That's tough. For now, you're holding kids over the edge for you now, Kev.
I got no kids. I got no kids in this battle, so I'll drop both of them. I don't give a shit.
I mean, hell, God.
Spider-Man got voted off. I'm upset.
I honestly, between the two of them, Assassin's Creed is just nostalgic, whereas League of Legends is currently good and I can always play it.
Well, I mean, Assassin's Creed for me is the same, like has the complete opposite. Like it's nostalgic, but I can play it again right now. Like
yeah, but it's just the same gameplay. Whereas you know, League of Legends is honestly
it's the same story you're gonna go through.
Yeah, but it's that good of a story that it can repeat 20 times and you can still be like, hell yeah.
I gotta go League of Legends because I still play that. And like, Zoro came over a couple weekends ago and he brought his laptop and we played League of Legends, even though we're both almost 30. And we still play, you know, video games together. So I have to go.
Nowadays, I don't think that being any older really matters anymore for video games. I feel like when we were younger and there was like 30, 40 year olds playing, that was when it was like, oh, those guys are weirdos for playing as older. But now that since we've literally grown up with it,
yeah,
now it doesn't seem like it's not weird.
But
not like
he came
like
over and we played League for like 6 hours. So
yeah, but
if you were doing
that every day, that'd be different.
No,
it was a special occasion, so why not? Go for it.
So League is my vote.
All right, Brian.
I'm gonna go with Assassin's Creed 2 just because, you know, like I said before, I have never played League of Legends, but I voted for it before because it sounded like an awesome concept up against the other game. But like,
I was going to say, you can't vote again for the game you haven't played. That just seems like against the rules somehow.
True. But Assassin's Creed gets my vote for this one because, you know, I've said it all. This game rocks. Yeah.
And I'm going to also do Assassin's Creed just because I'm a big fan of single player games. So like that kind of game I would even though I never really I've played it here and there, I think I've touched it, but I haven't like played through it. I would enjoy that more than I would enjoy League of Legends, I think, just because
and that one's more similar.
And
to...
also I play video games pretty much only by myself. I really never like even when we play Call of Duty and I play Call of Duty and stuff. I usually only play by myself.
Yeah,
it's just like I usually have like an hour or two. And I only can play it this time, so I'm like I'm not gonna go out of my way to like get a friend group together or people together to play because I'm like I only have this amount of time, so it's like I usually just jump on, play, get off.
Yeah,
well, if you're a fan of the Spider-Man game, you'd probably like Assassin's
Creed.
No,
I think I would.
Not, there's no talking and there's no reading.
It's more cutscenes. Yeah, I would like. Yeah, yeah. I played this one. I think I played like a like a handful of them here and there, like just, or maybe I just play when you guys had them, probably. So Assassin's Creed moves on to the...
So now it's Pokemon Red against Skyrim. Another one of my picks against each other.
This is the big one. This is hard. Not for me, but
also not for me. So Kev, you're gonna be the tiebreaker here for sure. Because I'm Skyrim all the way. Because I didn't.
I'm Pokemon all the way. Because I'm not a big. I'll play Skyrim, but I'm not a fan. Pokemon, I'll always, try to catch them all, baby. Kev's having a come apart.
Oh, this isn't fair.
Sorry,
I had to do this with mine. So now it's your turn.
This we're never gonna get to a champion if it was all easy. If it was an easy, it wouldn't.
It was my destiny.
Pokemon, it would all be. It'd be hard if it was all easy. It'd be boring.
I'm going to go with Pokemon because Pokemon. It's not like Skyrim is an amazing game, and I'll play it probably until the day I die. But Pokemon has so much to it. It's got the theme song, like Brian started singing. It's got the show. It's got, you know, Pokemon Go. It's got everything.
Oh, I do love Pokemon Go on the phone. Just it's a fun phone game too. Yeah,
it's got so much the franchise has to offer that. You just can't.
Pokemon go to the polls. Remember that stupid shit?
What?
Well, they like when
Hillary Clinton tried to appease young people by saying Pokemon go to the polls, and
that's terrible. Like, I didn't know that. That's
a
little,
like it's very pandery because it's like we know you don't play. You don't play Pokemon Go, Hillary. Come on, don't try.
Pokemans go to the polls. All right, so Pokemon moves. That was difficult for me. Pokemon moves up. So then it's Pokemon against Assassin's Creed.
I know where I'm leaning because
this is on me again. Why is this?
It's just the way the bracket shook out this week. It's just how it works. It's hard.
Assassin's Creed 2 all the way for me. Same reasons as before. Was never really super.
Oh yeah, he was not a Pokemon man. Games.
Yeah,
and so I'm Pokemon all the way. Pokemon. I'm Pokemon all the way because I didn't play Assassin's Creed as much as you guys. And also just
wait, is this for the championship?
Yes.
Oh shit.
This is on me again. Oh my goodness.
That's just the way it shook out, man. I can't help it. I can't make that bracket
the cookie crumble.
Yeah, it's just the way that everything is voted out.
Honestly, this isn't as difficult as the Skyrim one, so I'm gonna go Pokemon. Pokemon again, everyone knows Pokemon.
It continues to be good, even though like we didn't love the newer ones that came out, but you always can go back and play the old ones, and like I'm pumped for the. We should go and find like the OGs to like play.
I mean, I've tried to. There's if you want to buy Pokemon Red, like I'm pretty sure we have a Game Boy somewhere in our parents' house. But to buy Pokemon Red,
I have no idea where it would be.
To play, it's like probably $100.
Is
you
it
buy
really?
It on eBay for like $100. Like it's because it's an old game. Unless we can go find it at like a GameStop, like used or something.
Mm-hmm.
I want them to
you said they remade it.
Yeah, Pokemon Fire Red or Leaf Green.
Oh.
Fire Red and Leaf Green are Pokemon Red and Blue.
But just
redone for like Game Boy.
But it's with the original 150? Mm-hmm. Okay. You can play that too.
Yeah, but again, we don't own that, so we'd have to buy it. I would hate to buy a game that I've like owned 20 years ago. I don't want to.
Yeah,
I don't know. Because then it's more.
It might
more
be expensive. In the attic somewhere. Just ask mom and be like, "Hey, wait, she knows where everything is."
No, she doesn't.
She doesn't know where anything is.
Well, I mean, like everything is packed away somewhere.
I asked mom when.
Let's check out the paperclip box.
Well, she's not gonna like that. Listen, to
no,
that.
She's not gonna like that joke.
If she got all the end of this one, because she'd be like, "I don't know what any of these things are."
It's yeah, she definitely. She's not. We can say anything more right now. She definitely didn't finish this episode. No way.
Well, it's honestly funny.
Talking about video games,
I asked mom the
too much killing
weeks ago when Pokemon cards started being big again. I was like, "Where are Pokemon cards? We definitely had a lot." She's like, "Oh yeah, I know where they are." And she goes, and she comes back and hands me a bag of cards. And I'm like, "Mom,
you found them?
No, these are Yu-Gi-Oh cards, Mom." She's like, "No, they're not. These are the Pokemon cards." I'm like, "No, they're not. They're Yu-Gi-Oh cards."
Don't get it twisted. Yu-Gi-Oh and Pokemon are different. I think.
They're all the same.
I think our Pokemon cards have gone away somewhere.
They're somewhere in the void.
Yeah.
Mom gave them away or something.
She probably took them to the classroom or something like that.
No, I doubt it.
Nah. There's some... honestly, they're probably somewhere in the house, or two options, landfill or in the attic. That's it.
Yeah. The attic, there's nothing in the attic.
Yeah, there's nothing in the attic.
There's a lot of stuff in there. Yeah,
in the crawl space
in there.
In the crawl space.
No, in the attic above the house that you have to get through the tiny little.
Yeah, but there's not much up there because you don't. There's not much up there because you can't fit much up there. It's very skinny.
Exactly. There's bins up there. There's like skis up there. There's little bins up there. There's stuff up there that we will never ever ever need to have access to up there.
Don't want to throw out.
I guarantee, yeah, things that we don't want to throw out, but we don't need to have access to.
I doubt
in the near future.
I'm sure it's like, you know, all old pictures or whatever, and then Pokemon cards. I doubt that that's up there. That doesn't. Yeah.
Something's up there.
No.
All right, well, let's wrap this up because this is a long episode and we gotta get moving. All right, so Pokemon
is my pick.
Nice.
Last episode, my cousin Vinny was also my pick. Two weeks in a row. Let's go.
You're on fire. You're on fire here. I'll give credit where credit's due. A lot of my games, you know, didn't make it past the rounds, but Pokemon is definitely a fan favorite for sure.
The comedy movie one I had three of mine went past the first round at least, I think.
Yeah, but they didn't win.
Well, it's the democracy rules here.
You're not first, you're last.
Mm-hmm.
Ricky Bobby.
Shake and bake.
Thanks for listening, everybody. If Pokemon's not your number one choice, tell us what is. Go on our socials and tell us what you think is your favorite, and go from there. And we'll catch you guys next time.
All right. Please rate, subscribe, all that stuff.
All
Brothers
things.
Thrice.
Watch
Brothers
us on Thrice. YouTube. Enjoy it, everybody.
Peace.
Peace.
Brothers Thrice. Brothers Thrice.